世紀のスピードワゴン。
Robert E.O. Speedwagon has undoubtedly become one of the most beloved and respected characters in all of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure since the series' rise in popularity from its 2012 anime adaptation. But why do so many people love Speedwagon? I mean, he doesn't use Hamon, he isn't a stand user, and he could seem like a fairly average supporting character appearing in just the first two parts of the series, and even got on some people's nerves with his obsessive need to explain out loud everything happening around him. For some, it's only after you get more involved in the JoJo community that you come to find out people really love Speedwagon. So today we are going to take a deeper look into Speedwagon's character and the effects he had on the world of JoJo to understand why he's become the fan favorite and loved character he is today.
You like Speedwagon?
What kind of man doesn't?
Everything that Speedwagon lacks in supernatural ability, like being a Hamon or stand user, he makes up for with character and a massive sledgehammer. Speedwagon was first introduced to us as a street thug residing in the most dangerous part of London, Ogre Street, which is the same place he had grown up and lived for most of his life, making crime and violence pretty much all he's ever known. Speedwagon was a victim of poor circumstances, but he didn't let his fate determine the person he would become, and against all odds, he didn't let the bad people around him make him a bad person. Although it was a necessity to do some bad things in order to survive on Ogre Street, that's why when we first meet Speedwagon, he immediately attacks Jonathan. But him and his gang are met with the force of Jonathan's resolve, and just by being kicked in the face, Speedwagon is able to determine that this man is no ordinary Ogre Street lowlife, but rather someone fighting with true purpose and for a noble cause, forever branding Jonathan as a true gentleman in Speedwagon's eyes. Meeting Jonathan was all it took to reignite the good heart within Speedwagon and inspire him to live with purpose and fight for justice. So Speedwagon, with his newfound admiration for Jonathan, decided to leave Ogre Street and accompany him in his fight against evil. For the rest of Phantom Blood, Speedwagon plays the role of a loyal ally to Jonathan, gaining even more respect for him and his family throughout the part. And even after Phantom Blood, Speedwagon continues to support the Joestar family and aid them in their battles for generations to come. As after the events of Part 1, Speedwagon destroys the Stone Mask and sends Jonathan on his way. With no desire to return to Ogre Street, Speedwagon moves to America, the land of opportunity, and creates his own oil business, which successfully makes him one of the richest men in the world during the turn of the century. And with his newfound wealth, Speedwagon decides to express his good nature and better humanity by creating the Speedwagon Foundation, a multi-million dollar organization dedicated to animal and wildlife preservation, medical and scientific research, along with a supernatural research and development department that would study all things supernatural, including vampires, pillar men, Hamon, stands, and more. So even after Speedwagon's death post-battle tendency, he was still able to be an ally to the Joestars through the Speedwagon Foundation, providing them with information, protection, and supplies no matter what the situation may be or who they are. If you're a Joestar, you're a friend of Speedwagon. So for everything Speedwagon has done for the Joestar family for generations, it could almost seem questionable why Speedwagon had so much respect for Jonathan and for the Joestar family, and dedicated his life to their cause for as long as he lived and beyond. But from Speedwagon's perspective, doing what he did for the Joestar family was the least he could do to repay them for what they gave him. Jonathan was a symbol of justice that gave Speedwagon a new life. He gave him the opportunity to rise from the shadows of Ogre Street and become the good-hearted, successful millionaire philanthropist we knew him as. So to answer the question, why do we love Speedwagon? It's because he's a good person, humble, trustworthy, and directly participated in saving the world against Dio and the Pillar Men, as well as supported every other Joestar through the Speedwagon Foundation in their respective journeys. So if it wasn't for Speedwagon meeting Jonathan on that cold winter night in London, the timeline we know today would have been completely different, and some of our favorite Joestars may have never even existed. And who knows how much more Speedwagon contributed to humanity through the Speedwagon Foundation nation's medical and scientific research throughout the years. So if anyone ever finds themselves questioning why so many people love Speedwagon, just remember that in the grand scale of things, Speedwagon is one of, if not the most important and impactful characters in all of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. And that's going to be a video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. Please be sure to like the video if you enjoyed, as well as subscribe if you're not already and you would like to see more videos like this. A lot of exciting stuff coming up in the future. We are less than a month away from the premiere of the Part 5 anime. I cannot believe I'm even saying those words. So if you guys don't want to miss any Part 5 anime content, please be sure to stay subscribed because I'm sure there's going to be a lot of cool stuff coming out from that. So again, thank you guys for watching and have a good day. I'm out. Peace.